I'm going to finally do what I should have done a long time ago. I'm going to make a gauntlet that's just generic, that looks like it might be leather, that looks like a standard Batman could wear. And what I'm going to do now is I've got this piece of, I guess it's like copper pipe insulation. It's foam. And I've got a rag stuffed in there to make this area a little bit larger. It's basically the size of my arm. I'm going to now put clay on top of this, and I'm going to sculpt the clay. I shaped this with just packing tape. The gauntlet's going to be the full-length gauntlet all the way down my arm. I'll probably have like a flat area there so that any types of fins can be used for this in the back portion of this. I look forward to doing a variety of different fins that can go on this. So I'm going to create a generic piece. This is only going to be one, so I can do it for the left or the right. And I'm going to create one set of fins for each type of style. Pop them on there each time I make them. And people can use this for all different types of varieties of costumes. And I'm looking forward to being able to have this for my own costumes. And they're going to be able to be painted and aged and have different glove fins added to it and taken away. It's going to be pretty classic and pretty basic, generic, you know, the comic Batman. The kind that still uses the cloth gloves, you know, that doesn't have the styling of the movies, but just, you know, a basic glove that you put this gauntlet on any glove and make it look like it's a part of it. That's basically what I'm trying to do. So I'm getting started right now.
It's just like making a cake, folks. And, you know, it's going to be a very minimal amount of sculpting because it isn't going to be much larger than the arm, with the exception of the bottom flange. This is Chavant number 4. I've put it into the microwave. Get it to the point where I can spread it like a cake. We know that latex is going to shrink about 20%. What I'm going to do to make this very, very good for anybody who would want to use it is I'm going to take and make the flange come off the bottom of it. Like this knife, probably that far off actually. And that flange is going to make it able to fit just about anybody. And you probably can have a ability to cut that flange and widen it. Trim it down to a little smaller flange if you don't want one as big. So that's going to be the flexibility. We're almost there already, look at this. We're talking just about a few minutes and we've got, when this hardens, or not hardens, when it cools and it hardens, we'll be able to start sculpting. You'll be able to see a nice lip on the back. Make it look kind of finished, like a tailored glove. I've been thinking about doing this for about 20 years, and I don't know why I didn't. I guess I just, you know what it was? I just never really wanted to feel like I was doing like the whole costume. Even though this would have been a generic part, and I could have done it over the years, I just got caught up in other things, I guess. And we're almost there already. You've seen my other videos on the cowls. It's gonna be just like that. It's gonna be using the same techniques. This is just the beginning. Just to show you how it all goes on. Just to give you something to work with. There, look at that. All right, so there you go. So I ended up putting a flange on there. Look how cruddy that looks. I love how cruddy it looks. I love to take something that looks this cruddy and transform it into something that's really good. That's the fun part. And you see that video I did, I think it was the Dawn of Justice cowl. And I look back sometimes and I look at that picture that shows what the video looks like to start out. And it just looks like, I don't know, the thing or something. I don't know. The blob. And but you start out cruddy like this. And then you work it around. So then you just grab whatever tools you like working with. Spin it around. I'm going to get that shape. I'm going to fill in all these little craggy areas. And remember, this is going to be a glove that's going to be only, I'm only going to have one. So it's got to be symmetrical because it's going to serve for both. So that's basically the shape that it's going to be. Yeah, right there, something like that. You know, and you can trim off as much as you want if you got shorter arms. Anyway, that's it for this first stage. I've created mess. Mess has been achieved. And I'll go on and I'll make this all nice now. Get my blowtorch out, soften up a few areas once it's cooled, work on each area one at a time as it needs it. And I'm looking at this as being done really quickly. Usually I'll spend months on something. I'm doing other things at the same time though. So, you know, I'm replacing the top to my camper van. I've got so many other things going on. You know, I got a life, I'm a dad, you know, I got a family I got to take care of and do things with. I don't want to be all about superheroes, right? There's enough people out there to be about superheroes. I don't need to be one of them. There's so much superhero stuff going on. All right, anyway, that's enough for today. 10 minutes worth of sculpting. Gonna be what I'm gonna work with now.